Blackstone Publishing and Highlights for Children present All About Birds and Insects Collection.
A New Look at Hummingbirds by Jack Myers, Ph.D. People who love hummingbirds have a long list of reasons to watch them. Every one of these birds is an expert flyer and is almost always on the move. It will hover in front of a flower so steadily that its long, pointy beak can reach deep down inside. Then its tongue will lap up the few drops of sugary nectar. The hummingbird has been called nature's top athlete because it can keep this up all day long. All that activity takes a lot of energy, so the bird must keep flying in search of more nectar. That's an extreme case of fast food living. There is another part of a hummingbird's eating habits that is not so showy and has not received much attention. Hummingbirds must also eat some other kind of food. Sugar is a great source of energy, but that's not enough. Every animal needs a source of protein that it can break down and use to repair its muscles and other tissues. Careful watching of hummingbirds found their other source of food to be tiny insects that they catch as they fly. In their flights between flowers, they catch a few insects to round out their dinner. It's as if they are snatching a few pieces of meat while eating dessert. Sometimes a bird is lucky and finds its insects in a swarm. I once watched a hummingbird do a really special aerial maneuver. It dived down through a small swarm of insects, then flew back up to dive through the swarm over and over again. I had a rare view of the insect dining mode. I wondered then how a hummingbird could catch insects with its long pointy beak. Most insect-eating birds have wide mouths that look a lot better for catching insects as they fly. I found a report from two scientists who took repeated moving pictures of a hummingbird catching a fruit fly. The pictures showed that the beak could be opened so far that the mouth became extra wide. The base of the hummingbird's beak is bendy and can also open extra wide. Most insects were caught in the widest place at the base of the beak and not by the long, thin parts. Everyone can see that the hummingbird beak is beautifully shaped to reach deep inside flowers for their nectar. Now we know that the beak also has a special way to open extra wide for catching insects.
A peep inside a hatchery. At this hatchery in Pennsylvania, more than a million eggs are hatched each month. Millions of eggs are laid by hens on faraway farms. The eggs are packed into boxes and delivered to the hatchery in refrigerated trucks. At the hatchery, the eggs are put into trays. Inside each egg is an embryo, or developing chick. For the chick to grow properly, the hatchery must take the place of a mother hen. Hens sit on their eggs to keep them warm. So hatchery workers put trays of eggs into a big, warm room called an incubator. It holds 115,000 eggs. The temperature inside the incubator is 99.5 degrees Fahrenheit. 37.5 degrees Celsius, the same as a hen's body, and the air feels hot and moist. The warmth makes the embryos grow quickly. The yolks, yellow parts of the eggs, provide food for the developing chicks. After 21 days, the chicks will be ready to hatch. The incubator is not a good place for chicks to hatch because they could fall out of the trays. So on day 18, workers move the eggs into plastic baskets with tall sides. They slide the baskets into another large incubator called a hatcher. Peep, peep, peep.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.